Welcome back. This is an exciting video about creating a basket weave adaptive structure using adaptive points. So let's get started. I'll start off with a new family, a generic model adaptive.rft, and I'll create a long structure, a tube that matches the number of points that I am going to place. So I'll set my work plane first to the level and then create a point. And I'll do that 14 times, set the work plane to the level, make sure it's set to the level, and then start creating these 14 points. Why 14 points? Because I believe that I'm gonna need a 14 points adaptive for my basket weave structure. So once those points are placed, they don't need to be placed in a straight line, but you know, might as well, since it's better for them to snap to something, to the reference plane. Okay, once we have them, we can turn them into adaptive, make adaptive, and then run a spline through those 14 points. So the spline is that thin blue line you see there. Okay, then we're going to create a circle and set the work plane to a work plane perpendicular to that point or to that spline. Make that circle a 1 foot radius. So that circle is going to determine the radius and eventually the diameter of that tube structure that I'm going to place in my basket weave dome. Now, if you want this to be parametric, then you can create a shared parameter for that radius. And if you don't have a shared parameter file, then you may want to go ahead and create one. And then make sure it has the proper name, and then start creating a shared parameter group. I will call it all, A-L-L, and I'll create parameters within that. The first parameter is going to be radius, and I was thinking, should I call it radius of a tube or something like that? And then decided, you know, it doesn't really matter very much at this point. Let's just call it radius of tube. And this will be a length parameter, and we'll bring that into the generic model adaptive family. On the other side, along point 14, we will do the same thing, create a model circle, set to work plane, and that work plane would be the work plane perpendicular to that point in that spline. And same thing, we can do the radius as 1 foot. Obviously, you need to set the parameter of 1 foot shared parameter to both circles. Then we will select the spline and the two circles and create a solid form. Might as well create a material. I'll make that stainless steel, and I'll bring that from my library, AEC materials. Stainless steel polished. That'll work. And if you're going to be doing this the right way, you probably should set a shared parameter for everything you do, including the material parameter. So I'll simply add that shared parameter from the properties, change it to material type, and make sure that that's selected before you click the final OK. Okay, so now we are set. We can save this adaptive family, and then open a project. In the project, we need two reference planes. And I'm going to do this in the project environment because I'm going to utilize the array feature of Revit. All right, so we have two reference planes. We have two levels in there on the left-hand side. We're going to start working with our massing, and the massing create an in-place mass, set the radius to 50 feet. And then create a solid, and you can choose between a sphere and a cylinder. I'm gonna choose a sphere, and then do turn on the shading, and then I'll start. Usually I would like to finish the mass at this point. I'm gonna add a void form, go to the 3D view and stretch this down below the level, and then that will cut the in-place mass automatically because we are in edit mode. Okay, so I decided actually to finish the mass and then go ahead and edit it one more time, edit in place. And then at this point, I'm going to apply from the properties after I divide my surface into either 12 by 12 or 6 by 6 divisions. I think I'm going to go with 6 by 6. And then once the divided surface is set, then I'm going to apply the pattern on it. So there's different types of patterns that come with Revit. As you may know, if you have seen me do this for the past few videos, you probably know this by now. I'm just trying to show you different alternatives. I like the triangle, step triangle, bent, and I like the rhomboid and the rectangular. So the rhomboid may work. Let's change the U-grid and the V-grid to be 16 by 16. Let's see what happens. Yep, so this is gonna work. If you spin it around, you'll see that it has a nice curvature and it's just perfect for creating an adaptive family that's a tube around this pattern. So I like it. I'm going to go with that. No need to mess with it anymore. I'm going to turn on the surface and then go to the surface representation and turn on my nodes and original surface. And the nodes are important in this case, so I can snap to the nodes. So this is probably the most important part of this exercise, other than creating an adaptive family from adaptive points. All right, so we will add the nodes, and then we will finish the family and then save. Now I will load the adaptive family and turn off my levels. And basically at this point, you need to double check the number of points you have on the surface. You'll see in a moment where I was counting the nodes, and I counted 14, but then in reality there was a little bit more than that. So there is a fix around this. I'm just going to show you what part of the dome I'll be snapping to. Okay, so these are 9 out of 14 nodes. Okay, so we will load the 14 point adaptive and start placing it by using the point snap. In other words, SX is the keyboard shortcut for snapping to a point. Very important. So as I was creating those 14 points, seemed like it was working, and then I went just wild and created a few more of those, and then I realized I was short, so I was able to fix it quickly. I'll see in a moment. Very important that you know your geometry and plan ahead. So here we get to 14 points. Okay, so this works very well. And it looks cool. It wraps around it in a, you know, it's curved in two directions, so that's good. And as you look at it from the top view, you start realizing that that's not really the one in the center, right? So you want to put one in the center. So I end up putting two more. So in this exercise, I will be creating two versions of this dome. One that's highly symmetrical, and the other one, the next one, will be not symmetrical, and it will be like a basket weave. So just look out for two different solutions. Again, component command one more time, snapping to these points. And it does snap very easily if you have your notes turned on. And you go ahead and place them. It's kind of fun, you know. You can turn this around while you're snapping your points. That's a big plus, because you can't stop the process in the middle. Okay, so this is where I got a little bit short. I'm short one point, and I wasn't sure really why, although I was positive that I counted them. Okay, let's put one more. Obviously, this is just one example of what you can do with adaptive families that are made up of adaptive points. But the main thing is to get the geometry right first before you attempt to. So this is where I was short. So I was thinking, what can I do? Well, I mean, this is an adaptive family, so it can go anywhere I want, right? So it can be fixed. And for the purpose of this exercise, this video, I decided to grab the point and stretch it. And it just works very well. I mean, if this was a real project, you probably want to spend a little bit more time making sure you have the right number of points. Okay, so we have a good start. Again, I'm interested mainly in the array function of Revit in the project environment, not in the conceptual mass family. I'll use a radial array, I'll turn the number to 8, and I'll place, I tried to do the angle at 45, that didn't really work very well, so I had to repeat that one more time. Select one instance, right click select all instances, you can see the adaptive points show up on the plan view. Array one more time, radial, number is 8, this time I will not do the angle, I will do the place. So I'll use the place command and place my center of rotation at the intersection of the two reference planes, and then I'll do a 45 degree angle. As you can see, I get a fairly symmetrical top, but not above, not at the bottom. Okay, let's repeat that. This time, the number of the array is going to be increased from 8 to 16. And I will place center of rotation at the intersection, turn this at 22.5 degrees instead of 45 degrees, which is half that angle. And I, you know, you can start getting a little bit more intricate design. So I actually like this. I think this is one of the solutions for sure. There's nothing wrong with that. It's amazing what you can do given the proper geometry as the base. Next, we will delete two of the tubes and just use the middle one and then array it at number 32. Place the center of rotation at the intersection of the two reference planes. And this time we will turn it at half of that, which is 11.25 degrees. And then we end up with this situation. Okay, so this is where it gets interesting. It's a highly organized structure and I like it, but it lacks the basket weave. So how do you do the basket weave? The simple answer is by mirroring it. So you select all instances, the project, use a mirror command, pick axes. You always need those reference planes. And voila, we have a basket weave. So that's a symmetrical structure. So that's solution number two. I'm sure you can, if you do the same thing, you can come up with your own different or maybe better design than this. But this is a good start. And I, you know, you can do some magic with those patterns if you just understand your geometry. So for the rest of the video, I'm going to show you if you will, a Kodak moment, like what this thing will look like when you finally zoom in on it and get closer to it. And I'm going to place a camera on the inside and on the outside so you can see it from inside and outside. From inside, looks like it's ready for an arena, sports arena that is. I'm looking for the mass, turn off the mass, and I guess I'm going to have to go to the show mass tool in the massing menu and turn off the mass. So you always need to determine whether you're going to see this in hidden line or shaded or realistic. That would help a lot. And from outside, it's a little bit different, but this is very doable as a structure. Especially when it's parametric, you know, you can change the size of the tube, change the size of the pattern, you can play with it, but it's highly structured and highly symmetrical. So the question is, what is this for? You know, what's the utility for it? So that's a project specific situation. I hope you enjoyed this video and find it informative. And if you did, please subscribe to the channel and leave a comment below about what other topics that you would like us to cover in the future. Thank you and take care.